Welcome to my channel, Sunshine Shoulders. I'm Calvin. Thank you so much for stopping by today. Truly grateful. So many channels you could be watching. You're watching my channel. I never take that for granted. I stay in two-star hotels in the Philippines, not because I'm cheap, but because I know the difference. And in this vlog today, I'm going to save you some time and your valuable money. The Philippines is chock full of two-star hotels. That's mainly what it is, wherever you go. And I know when I came over here first few times, I spent a lot of my money on hotels because I didn't know the difference between five-star hotel, pension house, two-star hotel. So I'm going to share that experience and that knowledge onto you today. Not only is it cheaper, because I'm going to talk about that and the value, but let's talk about the location. And you see, I started this video where I did because I want you to see where I'm located, how far I am from my hotel. Everything's within walking distance. Now, Go Hotels, that's another two-star hotel, but that's not the one I'm staying in. There's the Jollibee. I just come from the bank. Now, I'm staying at the Tip Top Hotel. I think it's called the Tip Top Suite Inn now. They put a fancy name on it, in Dumaguete. It's right in the center of everything. Now, there's Robinson Mall, right across the street. Big, gigantic mall. There's Jollibee. Of course, you know, Robinson has all those restaurants inside. You're here on the main road, so if you wanted to catch a tricycle, a van, a bus, wherever you're going, you're right here. And you're going to notice that most two-star hotels are right in the center of everything. I'm going to take you past the laundry that I use when I stay here, because you're going to need a laundry. But location is a big reason why I use two-star hotels here. Everybody knows where the two-star hotels are. You're not going to have any confusion. When I arrived here from the Polar early this morning, about 3 a.m., I just got in the tricycle. I told him, hey, take me to the Tip Top. There's no explaining to him. There's no breaking out my phone, showing him on the Google. He knew exactly where it was. And that's a big advantage. Now, also, the food. One thing you're going to notice about two-star hotels, they always have a nice restaurant. The food is delicious. And I'm going to tell you why I figured it out. Because in these two-star hotels, there's no fancy qualifications. So there are a Lola, a working mother, to cook their food. That's why it's so delicious. I stayed in a two-star hotel in Zamboanga, the Two Seasons. And the little restaurant downstairs that was attached to the place, the food was some of the best I've had in the Philippines. I'm telling you now. I had the chop suey. I had the pizza, the fried chicken, of course, the breakfast. There's the laundry. There's the hotel I'm staying here, the Tip Top. Everything's in close proximity. So yeah, the food, and it's always cheap. It's always affordable. See, I was in the Navy. I was in the service, man. So I'm used to simple. I was talking to a guy the other night. He was from the Army. And we were talking about the same thing. I believe he was staying at the Bethel, which isn't too far from here. And he said he was paying like $20 a night. He said, well, I don't need anything fancy. And that's how I am. Because I'm going to tell you something, when it comes to the value, I get everything in this Tip Top that I would get in one of those fancy places that I'm going to pay double the price for. It's got the hot and cold water. It's got air conditioning. Yeah, it's a little loud, but so what? Put up with a noisy air con. It's really not really noisy. You'll be fine. But I'm staying here, as you can see, it's clean because of the time I checked in last night. It was 3 a.m. I didn't want to bother Heidi's cabin, even though she would have let me check in. I didn't want to do it. So yeah, the food. I'm going to get ready to eat breakfast now. It's a free breakfast here. This is $21. But I get everything in this place that I do in one of those fancy places that a lot of you guys stay in. Now, I'm not telling you how to spend your money. I'm just telling you, as a seasoned expat in the Philippines, I know the difference. I'm not trying to impress anybody. I've got a house, a nice place to stay. But when I'm traveling, especially by myself, or just me and Merlin, we don't get those fancy places because I've got cable, I've got internet, I've got everything that I would have in one of those fancy places for a third of the price, man. Philippines is full of two-star hotels. And, you know, beauty's in the eyes of the beholder. I've stayed in those one-star hotels before. It's not worth it, guys. You know, stay away from that. But a two-star hotel, absolutely. I've stayed in those flea bag places, but this isn't a flea bag place. Flea bag place. And let me tell you something, the woman you come over here to see, this is going to be good enough for her. This is going to impress her, believe it or not. The aircon alone, hell, the real mattress alone is going to, that's a real mattress. It's going to impress her. But another thing I like about checking into two-star hotels is the simple check-in process. When I arrived from the Polo this morning about 3 a.m., I didn't have time for all that fancy stuff. I came here, the guard checked me in, and even though I'm leaving today at about 12 o'clock, it was very convenient for me. There was no deposit I had to pay. There was no, oh, sir, come back. You can't check in to 2 o'clock, even though half the damn hotel is empty. He just checked me in. The guard, by the way. And I like that. You get the Philippine experience when you deal with these little mom and pop locations like this, these two-star hotels. I'm not going to tell you how to spend your money, man. You can spend your money any way you want to. But for me, this is enough. I mean, if you want a swimming pool, hell, you can go right up the street and swim. I don't know how much it's going to cost you. The Philippines is surrounded by ocean. But if you're just here and you want simplicity, you want budget, you want value, then I would say book you a two-star hotel, because believe it or not, guys, you're probably in a two-star hotel right now if you're in the Philippines. Okay? It runs the gamut from the Go Hotel all the way up to the Maawani, really. The Maawani, I would say it's a 2.5 because it has a nice swimming pool. But yeah, it's a simple check-in process. And I was dead tired last night. I didn't have a whole lot of time to be fooling around. I need to get checked in and get to bed, and that's what I did. So yeah, I like the simplicity of these two-star hotels. Okay, let's talk a little bit about value and price. Remember, I've got hot and cold water here. I've got cable, I've got internet. I got a free breakfast, a real mattress, and it's $21 per night in a great location, right in the center of the city, right across the street from a major mall. Everything that I want right in close proximity. And I've got the Philippines all around me. I'm not trying to be fancy. It's the reason why I've always lived among the locals. I want the Philippine experience. I don't want to pretend or to think for one moment I'm somewhere else. And that's what the value of a two-star hotel would give you. You see the security guard, he met me at the door. They've got 24-hour security here. You're not sacrificing safety or even comfort
for this, in this matter, when you decide to pay less, when you're with a Filipina for the first time, she's not going to tell you, hey, you know there's a hotel right up the street that's going to give you the same thing we're getting right now for half the price. She's not going to do it. She's going to do that later on as she gets comfortable with you. So you're going to spend a whole lot of unnecessary money, money that you're going to need on the back end of your trip. I'm an expat, man. I'm a seasoned expat, man. I'm a veteran over here. I'm not a passport bro. I'm not in and out of here, man. It's a big difference between being a tourist and an expat. See, don't shy away from expats because we can help you, man. We can give you some tips that's going to make you enjoy your 2 weeks here or your month here. And one of those is don't be afraid to check into a two-star hotel. But I'm not going to tell you how to spend your money. You know, a lot of guys, you know, they come over here, they don't want to get on the dating sites and things like that. See, when you check into a two-star hotel and you get that Philippine experience, remember, Filipinos, they have a talent for acting as if they've been knowing you for their whole life. I could easily go downstairs if I wanted to. First of all, there's a beautiful staff down there. But I could go down there and I could say, hey, you know, I've been here enough. They've seen me. They're comfortable with me. If I wanted to meet somebody, it would be so simple here. They're not putting on a whole lot of airs. There's not a whole lot of fancy requirements to work in a place like this. That's an advantage. They're not always trying to sell you something. If I want to buy something, I'll buy it. That's one of the first principles of selling that I learned. Stop trying to sell people something. If they want it, they'll go out and buy it. It's the same way here in a two-star hotel. But I just want to share these little tips to my new viewers and subscribers who've never been here, who have an interest in coming here, who are on their way here. This is the type of stuff that will save you time and save you money, your hard-earned money. You're going to need it on the back end of your trip. So when you come here, you're right in the middle of the city. The location is great. Look at all of this. I'm within walking distance of everything. My bank was right around the corner, PNB Bank, which my main branch is in San Carlos City. The M. Lawyer, Palawan, if you need to remit money to yourself. The Robinson for everything you need. Remember, we're about 5 minute tricycle ride from the boulevard here. $21 a night. You get everything you're going to get at one of these fancy places. Your woman's going to be satisfied. She's going to be impressed. This is enough for her. We have a tendency to overspend when we come to the Philippines, guys. The food is going to be delicious. Every two-star hotel has a great cook. I promise you that. Because they don't require a college education. And some of the best cooks don't have a college education. So thank you so much for stopping by today. Really appreciate it. You're in America, it's late. Before you let your head hit the pillow, I hope you find somebody to help. If you don't want them late grocery runs, beer runs, weed runs, just getting off second shift while you're on your lunch break, you see somebody on the street, buy them something to eat, buy them something to drink, give them a few dollars. If you're in the Philippines, I guess it's about 10:20. I'm going to go to the bus station, headed back to San Carlos City. Now, a day goes by, I don't help somebody. I'll tip the driver, I'll tip the waitress more than they want to. I'll do the spin wheel. There's no excuse not to help somebody over here. Somebody help me in my time of need. Because if I don't know anything else, I know this one thing for sure. When we help other people, we help ourselves. Take care, stay safe, stay COVID-free. I'll see you next time.